that song was blessed.
Yes.
Blessed. Amen. All right, so we're at number three for the relationship series. I'm going to talk about a very familiar text. I needed to be able to see. All right, some of y'all know about glasses. And running. All right, so I'm going to talk from the topic, you're not the only one. You're not the only one. You're one of the ones. All right, somebody knows about that today. All right, we're going to make it through this scripture here. I'm going to use David and Bathsheba. And it came, this is from 2 Samuel chapter 11. It came to pass in an evening time that David arose from off his bed and walked upon the roof of the king's house, And from the roof he saw a woman washing herself. The woman was very beautiful to look upon. And David sent and inquired after the woman. One said, "Is not this Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?" David sent messengers and took her. She came in unto him, and he lay with her, for she was purified from her uncleanness. And she then returned unto her house. The woman conceived and sent and told David, and David said, and she said to David, "I am with child." And we know that later on in that particular text that David then put her husband on the front line so that he might be killed. All right, and so that is a story I'm going to talk from on today. Now, the question I want everybody to ask themselves is, will you settle for being any number? Or is it your goal to be the only number? Thank you.
That part. Come on.
Will you settle for being any number, or is it your goal to be the only number? Sometimes we gotta wake up and smell the coffee and realize that that is what we are dealing with. And y'all know in these relationship series, I'd like to give you some scenarios to think about and to consider. All right, and so if you meet someone who is currently involved, they disclose that to you that they are involved, they have somebody. In other words, you need to bow out graciously and respect that. That's what I'm saying to you all today. All right, so now when you hear that they are with somebody, you might even see them with somebody, you might need to bow out graciously. Don't think because they spoke to you or they looked at you, some of us have this thing about folks looking at us across the room. Don't think because they looked at you that it is now your opportunity to get to know them better and make yourself available and now make your move. Somebody better hear me today. Looking doesn't always mean that they're attracted to you. Y'all know how some people start planning a wedding just because somebody looked at them. Somebody say, "This is the Lord speaking." I've had people tell me they had a dream about somebody who was already married. "That's my husband, that's my wife." Well, they already with somebody else. The Lord couldn't have told you that. All right, and so now, y'all would not believe how many times I've heard that. But y'all have gotten rid of the mate or the person they're with already just because you've gone somewhere else in your mind. It amazes me some of the extremes people go through to get that other person free. And y'all saw what David did. He put the woman's husband on the front line of the battle to make sure that he would not return, that he would be killed in battle. And so today, I want to tell you, don't go somewhere in your head and start judging that person's mate who you don't even know and thinking they deserve somebody better. And that better person is you. It amazes me how men and women are on the hunt for somebody. they thus become, when they're on the hunt, they thus become the better person, better than everybody else, better than anybody else. Anybody whom is already taken, they become better than that spouse, they become better than that significant other, they become better than the partner, they become better than the girlfriend, better than the boyfriend, they just become better than anybody else. In essence, they start making that person's significant other a horrible person. They make that person become the person who ain't doing enough for their man or their woman. They make that person the person who is lazy and not worth that other person that you're chasing, not worth that time. They make the other person, the partner, become the worst person on the planet. I want to say today, stop buying into your own hype. Stop buying into your own hype. Stop listening to that spirit that's sitting on your shoulder telling you all this stuff. All right, when you buy into your own hype, you then start whispering in people's ears. Y'all know how we like to whisper little stuff in people's ears. You whisper, he's not going to treat you like I will. You whisper, he's not going to do the things for you that I'm going to do for you. You whisper, I can give a mad massage and a memorable rub. You will not be the same when I get through with you, and you'll forget all about him and that you ever met him. We started whispering those types of things. We whispered to her, she doesn't know all the spots that I know. Somebody has said that before. We whisper to her, she can't kiss you like I can. We whisper, she can't touch you and make your body convulse and make you float on air like I can. And when I get through with you, you won't even remember her name or remember what she looks like. Somebody's been whispering in here before. You get bold because you have bought into your own hype. You get bold and extra confident listening to that spirit that's sitting on your shoulder. Now, I'm in no way saying don't be confident. I'm definitely not saying that don't be confident in yourself. We always want you to be confident in yourself. However, I am saying stay in your lane. Stay in your lane. If they have somebody, drive on a different street, drive on a different block, drive in a different lane on that street. Especially now, when you don't know what that other person is doing or who that other person is. Go find a single person to do all that talking to. Find a single person to do all that whispering to. Find a single person to do all that sexting to. Y'all know what sexting is, right? That's where you send in those nice messages on text message. We're going to say it that way. Y'all know what nice messages is on text message, right? All right, those are considered inappropriate text messages, Tina. That means hopefully you ain't sending them. All right. All right, and find a single person to do all that rubbing on. That's what I want to tell y'all. They're single, you're single. That's a good match right there. Put your energy into that. Leave what somebody else put their energy into getting. Leave that alone. All right, I'm saying leave that alone. And let me say this, for all of those who are afraid of commitment, and that's why you talk to folks who are already committed, leave that alone and go and find your own. I want to tell somebody, it might not be any of you in here, but it might be somebody watching. Grow up. Understand commitment is not something to be afraid of. All right, commitment is something that you have to work on, your significant other has to work on, and you will work on it together. Eventually, it will grow into something awesome, or it might not. That's a chance you have to take. But you have to be willing to give it a chance and not try to sabotage every relationship you're in when it comes time to make that commitment. We talked about sabotage 2 Sundays ago. And so some people, when it's time to commit, it's time to be serious, time to go to the next level, they then begin to sabotage the relationship. And so you cannot do that. And get this now, if you're able to pull that person who is involved, let's just say, you know, you start talking to somebody else. I knew it was going to be quiet today. Let's just say you start talking to somebody who's got somebody, and you're able to pull that person who is already involved with somebody else. What you going to do with them now? You just might be relieving somebody and taking on their problem. Be careful about thinking you've one up somebody. We always want to say, yeah, I got her man, I got her woman, I took his man, I took his woman. They might have just one up you. All right, somebody better wake up. Wake up. That person that you were so desperate to have might be a person that's hard to deal with. That person you were so desperate to have might be the one who sits around and refuses to do anything. That person you were so desperate to have might be the one who pushes the toothpaste from the middle, which annoys the mess out of you. They may be the one who leaves the end of the toilet roll and never seems to be able to find the other roll of toilet paper to change it before you come in there. They might be the one who refuses to ever buy any groceries but eats everything. They might be the one who leaves the car on E and when you get in to go somewhere, you don't have any gas. They might be the one who does those things that pushes all of your buttons. All right, so that you might not want to be in such a hurry to one up somebody and get what belongs to them. All right, somebody better listen to God and hear God and try the Spirit. All right, if they are that easy for you to pull and have dealings with, what does that say about them? And what does that say about you? And oftentimes, if they that easy to pull, you ain't gonna be the first to pull them and won't be the last. All right? With you, I hate to use this term in the church, but this is a series. This ain't the preaching hour. This is a teaching preaching hour. All right, but with you, they will probably hit it and quit it. Let me say it that way. All right? Y'all wanted to hear it. All right? Anybody know about hitting it and quitting it? That's where you are simply a booty call. They call you late. They call you in the dark. They call you so nobody else can see you. You are often a trick or a treat that is unknown to the world. And when they get through with you, they go back to the one that they were with all of the time. All right, so somebody better recognize when you are simply a booty call. When they are simply hitting it and quitting it. Many times, let me say something about these kind of folks that do this hitting and quitting it. Because the lesbian and gay community is not any different. We know that happens in the heterosexual community as well. Many times, these player types get with you, and when they get through with you, they throw you a sign. They stop returning your phone calls. Anybody ever experienced that? Or maybe your friends have experienced that. All right, let's give it to your friends. All right? They don't return your text messages. You blowing up their phone, sending paragraphs and dissertation text messages to them. All right? They don't return those text messages. They block your number unbeknownst to you. They don't answer the door when you creep over their house and say you're going to show up and surprise them. Some people I know have shown up with nothing on but a coat, thinking they was going to go and seduce somebody. Their friends no longer associate with you. Y'all are quiet. I know I ain't the only person that know people who knew this stuff. All right, maybe y'all saw it on TV. Let's go there. All right, they don't bump into you anymore. They, in essence, want you to forget you ever knew them. So they stay away from all the places that y'all used to go and all the places where they know that you're going to be. And so that is truly a hit it and quit it. They have quit you and want you to move on. Nowadays, let me add this, they also delete you from Facebook. They delete you from Snapchat and Instagram. And they report you if you try to contact them or find them and say you are stalking them. And watch out for those who so easily stray away from their commitments is what I want to say. All right, so now I hope that y'all are getting this message.
Amen.
Now, there are some in that same vein who say, don't call me, I'll call you. All right, anybody ever heard that before? Some of y'all have told folks that I can look at your face and say, you've been the one telling folks, don't call me, I'm going to call you. All right? And that means when they have time from the person that they're with, they'll call you. Which means you're no longer at the top of their list. But they want to keep you hanging on just in case they want to change it up a little bit. Y'all know about those people who need to change it up? They want to change it up and come and partake of the things you are doing that you did to try to keep them. So every now and then they'll come back to that. But in other words, that means that they're going to call you probably every 6 months and make you wait patiently, make you sit lonely, make you look desperate, and have you unhappy until the next time you hear from them. Now y'all know I'm telling the truth, but it's quiet in here today. So now ask yourself, what kind of life is that? What kind of life is that? Well, you're not the number one. That's what we're talking about. That's what we're talking about. Then you have the nerve. Let me tell you this. When you know you're not the number one, sometimes you're not number two, you're just the booty call, or you're the person on the side. You have the nerve to tell the world you got somebody. You got the nerve to tell the world. You got their pictures hanging up. You got all their favorite stuff at your house. You got something special waiting on the bed and in the bathroom just in case they come by. You text them messages each and every day since you can't see them, because you are ready and you are waiting. The more you text them, let me tell you, the less they call you. The more you start emailing them, the less you hear from them. Be careful of those who tell you they need a little more time in order to decide to deal with you. Somebody better hear me. Be careful of those who tell you they need a little more time before they can make up their mind or decide to deal with you. But get this now. Each time that person came through, because that's all they were doing. Y'all know that's all they were doing was coming through around. Because they was going back home, going back to somebody's house. You are thinking each time they came through, you're thinking you're going to do enough to get them to stay. You're going to do enough to steal them. You're going to do enough to have them move back into your arms. Move them to what you dream about every night. Move them to what you told your friends about. Y'all know we all got that friend, right? That friend that you talk to and tell everything to, even about those relationships where the person has somebody else. You feel when they come through that if you can get them to scream loud enough, things will change. Somebody's tried that. You feel if you get their bodies to do some things it has not done before, and they can call your name, then they'll be back with you. Somebody's tried that before. You feel if you get them to spend the night or spend a weekend or maybe even spend the day with you, they'll see what they are missing and they'll rethink where they have placed you in their lives. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I came to tell you, you ought not want to be with anybody that you have to convince that you are the one and that you're worthy of their time. You ought not want anybody who does not want you. Don't chase behind anybody who ain't willing to chase behind you. Understand your worth and understand your value. Develop some principles. One of the problems I see in relationships today is that people don't respect themselves. If you respect yourself, you would never allow anybody to play with your heart. You wouldn't allow them to play with your mind. You wouldn't allow them to play with your emotions. No, but you allow them to play with your spirit. But you gotta respect yourself first. If you respected yourself, you would not allow anyone to make you a side thing, a booty call, or something they just do every now and then. If you respected yourself, you would not allow anyone to abuse you, use you, and simply toy with you as if they are actually going to do something with you. I came to tell somebody that's desperation on your part. If you allow anybody to play with you like that, shame on you. You must move into a place where you respect yourself, where you love yourself, and where you honor the person that God has created you to be. Respect yourself enough to say, I'm not going to settle for being number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever number. If I can't be number one and the only one, I'm going to go somewhere where I can be the number one. Sometimes you got to just talk to yourself and encourage yourself like David did. Respect yourself enough to say, I'm not willing to sit around waiting for you to make up your mind about what you want to do with my life. I'm not waiting to sit around waiting for you to make up your mind when you can be free from me and when you can do some things with me. I'm not willing to sit around while you make up your mind and say that you got to take some time to choose whether I'm worth your time or worth your commitment. You got to make up your mind that you are a good thing. Somebody needs to tell yourself, I am a good thing.
Yes, yes.
Make up your mind, church. Make up your mind that you are worthy of somebody's love and worthy of somebody's time. I need somebody to tell yourself, I love myself too much to keep playing and be a pawn in somebody else's game. You gotta love yourself. You gotta respect yourself. You gotta honor the God that is in you. You gotta honor the temple that God has given you and stop doing all these things against the temple that the Spirit of the Lord dwells in. God loves you. You have been fearfully and wonderfully made. And you got to know that if that person you are messing around with does not want you, there is somebody else out there who does. You got to know if that person you are messing around with cannot treat you right, there is somebody else who will. And that's why I always say, if you don't want to do right, there is somebody else who will. And so sometimes you might have to let that other person know. There's always somebody in the wings. There's always somebody else out there who will do what you won't do. So you can't straighten up and do what's right. There is somebody else who will. Church, sometimes you just have to remind yourself of your own value. You all have value. You all have purpose. You all have a destiny. You all have gifts. And you all have been uniquely made by God. So you don't have to put up with this foolishness that is going on today. One of the things I noticed is that people watch these shows where the man, the Bachelor show, where the man has 20 folks that he's trying to pick from. I didn't like that show from the beginning. I said, because that was going to put out the wrong spirit to many people that you have to tolerate somebody having a whole bunch of people that they are going out with and doing things with and saying that they have to pick from. And you have to know about the other person has to know about you. All right, and so that has set the wrong tone in our society on today. And you can decide if you want to participate in that or not. The choice is yours. But you ought to want somebody who wants you. All right?
Amen.
And so I understand that in this community there has been a lot of hurt. I totally understand that. I totally get that. I totally empathize and sympathize with that as well. Having a good time and looking over the pain is often what people do in order not to have to deal with what happened to them in their lives along the way. How somebody abused them, how somebody violated them, I understand that totally. That is a survival mechanism. And to me, the reason people act as if all they want to do is have a good time is because healing has not occurred in their hearts. Nor has healing occurred in their spirits. So therefore, that says to me that they need to go and see a therapist and have some counseling and do some work on themselves in order to receive the healing that God has for them. But once you've been healed now, once you let some things go, you move to a place where you want to be settled. You move to a place where you want to have calmness. And you move to a place where you say you're no longer going to deal with 4, 5, or 6 men in your life and try to sleep with all of them. You move to a place where you say you're no longer going to have 2, 3, or 4 women that you deal with and try to go between all of them. And sometimes even have all of them at the same place at the same time. When you become settled, it means that you are settling down with one. And you'll make that one your one and only. And turn your life around to receive the blessings of the Lord. I don't know about you today, church, but there is a peace that comes in your life when you only have one person to deal with, and one person to love. Number one will stand with you in the midst of adversity. Anybody know that? Number one will stand with you when it seems the world is coming against you. Number one will be there in the midnight hour when things are rough and it seems like the world is turning upside down. Number one will be there. Anybody got a number one? Number one will help to pick you up when you you